All right, welcome back to another
Hey, Ernie Johnson here, and
episode
I'm
of
joined
A
by
New
Kenny
Place
the Jet
NBA
Smith and Shaquille
2K18. I'm
Welcome to the
SRD.
NBA on 2K Sports.
If you remember last time,
Tonight's
Coach announced that
to
I was going to be starting this game. I hope he keeps his promise.
Celtics
Let's see.
So y'all know me. You know, I'm like, hey, I'm Sham. You can't be talking to me like
that.
Hey,
what's
hey,
up,
DJ?
What up,
DJ? Hey, man, you a starter?
Hey, what? You started?
Hey, man, get out of here, dude. This grown folks business.
All right, you're talking about it.
So fast, man.
Wolford not happy though. I took his spot, didn't I? Unless he's playing like a forward position.
Hey, but listen, man. Don't make the same mistake as me. All right. When I first got out there, I just went out and started.
Yeah, you just shot everything that came your way. Look, I saw the tape.
Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
DJ, how you feeling? I feel great, coach.
What about me, coach? You asked me how I was feeling.
Oh, I'm sorry, Shammy. How you feeling
today?
All right,
today? Well, since you're asking me, look, I was over here telling you, look, you just got to let the game flow like water, you know? Don't get out there trying to do too much, trying to create your own offense. It ain't going to work out.
That's very sage advice, DJ. Let me tell you, Shammy's only telling you that so he can get more shots.
Oh, no, that's no, it. That's not true at all. Y'all got me stereotyped. No way.
No, but in all honesty, you're going to have a million people trying to give you advice today, DJ. Just play your game, all right? Play the way they got you. You'll be fine.
I got it, coach. I'm ready.
Season starter.
He got it, coach. He ready.
I know he is. Hey, you. I saw a mess in the men's bathroom. Follow me.
So is that really how it sounds?
Oh, I want to start, Sham. When you gonna let me play?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, you kind of sounded like,
no, oh, why is my rookie so much better than me?
Better than me?
Yeah.
You'll never be better than me.
Yeah, we'll see.
All right, well, let's just go.
DJ, what was the name of that 2 Chainz song you was playing earlier?
Feds Watching?
No, that other one.
Oh, Bounce.
Yeah, I like that one.
True.
You want a protein bar?
Nah, I'm good on protein, bro.
All right, let's get in the game. We're going to be starting.
Remember to hydrate.
I don't think I've ever done a jump ball. This would be like the first time if I start in center. Okay, we're playing at the Celtics Arena, taking on the Milwaukee Bucks, who are 9-12. We are 15-9.
This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg.
Should be a game that we should be able to win. Look at him out there. Look at him ready to go. Him and Kyrie.
Hey, guys, one more milestone for what has become one of the best stories in the NBA. After going undrafted and fighting onto the roster, DJ has played his way into a starting role. Now, the rumors of coach making a change have been floating around, but tonight he decided to shake things up. He said we'll see how long it lasts, and as of tonight, he's going forward with DJ in the starting lineup.
All right.
Thanks, David. Just another big game and moment for DJ, who you can't help but
you. Oh, I just missed it. I ran right through it. Daggone it.
Looking to turn things around and save their season.
All right. Oh, okay. I'm not starting center. Wolford's still going to be. Where am I at? Like power forward? Big forward? Small forward? I'm not the small forward.
Who are we?
Who I got? Somebody who's a lot faster than me, I'm sure. Okay. Yeah, he's a lot faster than me. I'm going to have to give him some attention.
And then attention to detail.
I didn't foul him, did I?
For Milwaukee. All the big bucks up front. Giannis, Parker, and Maker. Brogdon and Middleton are the guard tandem.
Well, I tell you what, he is a deceptive athlete. When you look at Jabari Parker, he does a lot of things easily from an athletic standpoint. He's stronger than he looks, has much bounce and agility. Man, I love this guy's upside. Just hope he can stay healthy.
8 feet away. And
oh, you're kidding me. Thought I had that easily.
And it's the Bucks ball. It's a three-point game. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
And let's go. Come on. Don't let us down there. DJ, get out there.
Really never got any resistance from the D.
And you know, Greg, they were sinking shots left and right, and that's got to be demoralizing for the defense.
All right, 0 for 2, man. Let's start passing the ball around. Wait for the right shot. Just because I got the ball doesn't mean I got to take it to the hoop.
Antetokounmpo passes to Maker. Six on the shot clock. For three, Brogdon. That one doesn't go. And the Celtics going the other way now. They come into this having outplayed Phoenix the last game.
Really? An intimidating
defense.
I mean, they challenged everything.
Well, come on, man.
And that led them to victory.
Greg, they expended maximum energy, but it was well worth it. I mean, they earned that win with their defense.
All right, coach, I'm sorry. I thought I got hacked.
Bucks have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Kicks it to Middleton. Screened by Parker. Back to Brogdon. Fires the three. Nope, not that time. Nothing.
All right, got a board. Let's go.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Okay. Well, don't stop four shots, man.
Antetokounmpo kicks to make. Brogdon against Irving. There's a screen. Four on the clock. Maker, no one around him. Milwaukee, no good that time either. For Boston, they've gone 0-4, missing their first four field goals. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Boy, you take a look at Jason Kidd, and he's clearly one of those players that just has a mind for the game. Throughout his career, you saw how well he saw the court.
Oh, come on. Come on, man.
Scoring chances for his teammates. And was also very heady at the defensive end. One of the very cerebral Hall of Fame players we've had in the
got
history.
Got one. All right. Man, he's good on terrible. Can't get my timing down on foul shots at all.
That when he got into coaching, he just said, of course, it makes too much sense given how much of an on-the-court leader he was.
Yeah, and you know what? You're exactly right. I felt the same way about Kidd. And when you play with some players, you just get that feeling with how they approach the game. And even in your role as a broadcaster, mine too, we get to talk to players and we get a feeling of whether they'll coach or not. Even in college, you could tell he was a special player with kind of a view of the game as well.
And
this
dang it.
Quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Offensive rebound. And that's good. A nice job in the glass as they pick up two on the second
putting
effort.
Putting their hurts to it. Let's go, team. Let's go.
Second effort on the glass from Parker. This guy never gives up on the offensive glass.
Now here's Smart, defended by Middleton. 17-foot shot on the way. Smart misses. Bucks leading by six. Outside, Antetokounmpo. And it's Parker in the corner. And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way. Now let's take a look at the top rookies in the league. Our rankings here for the race for Rookie of the Year. Function every young player would love to have. When you look at the monster, not really the start he wanted to have for his NBA career, but the season is young. He can still fight his way, guys, into the conversation.
And clearly, he's still finding his footing in the league. It hasn't been quite as smooth.
Wolford, man, what are you doing ball handling?
Many had hoped for.
But there are reasons to be encouraged, Greg. I mean, we've seen some flashes of brilliance from him, and I imagine there's more in store.
Now, here's Smart. He's tightly guarded.
Yeah, here we go.
Look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that dish.
Milwaukee in the lead. Antetokounmpo with the ball. He had 19 points in the win against Sacramento.
And he was terrific in that game defensively as well, blocking four shots on the night.
Irving kicks to Horford. Good. In the
there we go. Nice move.
Horford's got his first basket of the night.
Dime.
A top-notch postgame is just one of the ways Horford helps his team. One of the more important ways, though, is because he's a tough matchup down low.
Maker with a screen for Antetokounmpo.
Oh.
An easy layup after coming off the pick. Antetokounmpo has got his first basket.
Just a lovely touch on that little flaw from Antetokounmpo. You know, that's a nice little shot to have in your repertoire. This guy is the full and total package.
Here's the teardrop. Hayward can't.
Come on, man.
Typically he has
the pick and roll going there, man.
When he's in tight, but not sure on that position.
To the inside. Maker misses. Celtics trail by six. tries it from the top of the key, and the jumper is good.
There we go. Oh,
that was a terribly difficult shot, but still, somehow, some way, it went down. Wow.
Brogdon kicks to Parker. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet. Parker's got 7 points.
It's been a very efficient first quarter for him. He's creating good opportunities and converting those that he creates.
Here's Irving. That's short off the rim.
Not sure what the D
get
was
up
doing
in the air, man.
Clearly
come on.
A breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And Middleton kicks to Antetokounmpo. They set the pick. Middleton dishes to Parker. And the dunk by Parker.
And you know, whenever Parker charges into the paint, you just probably need to get out of the way. Because when he's got his speed under him, a good head of steam, he can throw it down with the best.
All right, we're down by 8. Let's go, boys.
First timeout called here for Boston. And Greg, when Jabari Parker is healthy, he has shown that he can be a go-to scorer in this league.
Parker reminds me a bit of how...
Okay, I get back in, and we are down by 11.
Quarter number 2, we're about 2 minutes in. Brown and Hayward out on the perimeter. The monster out there with Horford, and it's Irving at the 1. That's the Boston 5. Wilson with the block. Now the Bucks moving it up. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the monster in the last game against the Suns was superb. He ended with 16 points, and in addition to his scoring, he also finished with a season high in rebounds. It was a great performance. Talking to his teammates, they all hope it's a sign of bigger things to come. See how he progresses tonight, Kevin.
All right, here's three.
Could you believe that performance? Wow.
I mean, it was really something to see. Yeah, he showed everybody just how special he is when he is on his game.
No.
Greg, something really stoked his fire. Man, there was no holding him back. And when a player is that locked in, you just got to sit back and enjoy the ride.
The 10-footer.
Drop.
Opportunity and plenty of contact on the shot. So, 2 free throws coming up. And Milwaukee gets called for the foul.
And it's always been talked about how the NBA is a brotherhood. And DJ has fit right in.
Got the rebound. I didn't see it.
From what I hear, he's already becoming tight with the other stars around the league. Well, we've seen the change in the starting lineup. And I'll be the first to say that I like the move.
Damn it. That was not even close.
Into that group.
He's come on.
It with his play.
Come on, DJ.
Looks much deadlier when he's on the floor.
Marcus Smart's checked
nope.
in for Brown.
Missed them both.
And he ends up
pitiful.
Missing both free throws.
Pitiful.
You know, the getting to the free throw line is almost a skill unto itself, Clark. Which players are elite in your mind in their ability to draw contact?
Well, Kevin, one of the first guys that comes to mind is James
Come
Harden.
On, man. That was a good
Westbrook
foul.
Would be another so good at attacking.
I can't
the
get
defense,
going, man.
Putting their bodies into the defender. And because of that, they make it hard for the defenders to guard them without fouling. But those two guys come to mind right away. And having that skill of drawing fouls.
Well, Thon Maker is a project player, Clark, for his team, taken 10th overall in the 2016 draft. Has great size and he moves well, but it's going to be a few years before he gets to where he needs to be.
I agree with you, but with big guys, you can afford to be patient when you see that they have a work ethic and a commitment.
What are you doing?
Are willing to learn and grow, and then you factor in his athleticism and size. I think it's a weight that's going to pay big dividends for the Bucks.
Come on, Kyrie.
Shot goes
yes.
down. Very quick possession right there.
He's just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
Antetokounmpo with the ball. Now guarded by Smart. Milwaukee, no good that time either. Celtics trail by 12. The shot by Hayward, wide open. Off the mark and a chance to trim it to single digits. To the paint. Here's Maker and a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. 6 points for Thon Maker.
And Antetokounmpo does it all. The Greek freak, a total team player who has a motor that doesn't quit, and he's very unselfish with the ball.
Here's Smart. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. Now with this break, let's check out just how the rebounding has been divided up in this game between the front and backcourt for Milwaukee.
And their bigs are doing the heavy lifting on the boards. Everybody's
all right.
Business right now, and that's why we
another assist
with a comfortable lead.
Well, I tell you what a well-designed play, executed beautifully too.
And Milwaukee calls their first time out of the game. Last time they met was in Milwaukee.
Yeah, they gave up.
I'm by 12, man.
Defense constantly breaking down way too many times.
Let's go.
Yep, and that's not a winning performance.
Let's get back in this.
Tighten up the defense moving forward if you're going to get some W's.
Wilson the pass to Antetokounmpo. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Good on the three-point shot.
Oh. Shot.
Got 14 points.
Come on, what is going on, man? Let's go.
Today he set the bar for the rest of the team.
Irving kicks to Hayward. Here's the monster, and he uses the glass.
All right.
5 points in the game.
Defensive rebounding, just such a crucial part of the game.
Yeah, it's finishing your defense, Greg. We know that. You can defend, then you got to rebound the miss, and you got to get to the glass with intensity.
Maker misses.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
Good.
You know that part
all
of the
right.
Floor,
man, I had inside position too.
His real sweet spot, right in his wheelhouse.
Bucks leading by 11. And Middleton kicks to Antetokounmpo.
No, 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 no. A little slippery.
Back
slippery.
To pass to Maker. Let's it go from 14. Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. Middleton's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Off the screen. Again, the Celtics good for two.
Here we go.
You can see there the defender gets caught up on the pick.
I think he's got to be more aggressive, stronger, getting through those screens. Can't allow shooters that kind of space to pull the trigger.
There's the pick to the right side. There's Parker with the three, rebounded by the Celtics.
And you know what? Right, he can't get a better screen, frees him up beautifully, but he just fails to capitalize.
Clearly a frustrating.
You got to take better shots, man.
There. Perfect screen, got him the space he needed, but he bricked it.
Celtics trail by 13. Irving passes to the monster. Hayward outside. Picked by Horford. Shoots from the elbow. Misses off the right iron.
You know, he's been off so far, Kevin, but there's still time. I mean, he just needs
somebody
to
get him.
Settle
somebody
it
get
down,
him. All right.
Idle it down a little bit and try to contribute as much as he can on the offense within himself.
Left side, Antetokounmpo on the mark with the 15-footer. Antetokounmpo's got four this quarter.
He's done a nice job, a great job, actually, of finding efficient shots here in the second. Shooting percentage always a function of the kinds of shots you get. And he's on a good roll after struggling a bit in the first.
Here's Irving. The shot is good. It's his second bucket in 5 tries.
Boy, I tell you, I don't know if there's anybody better than Kyrie Irving close to the basket. He has a great feel for how to score inside.
Middleton dishes to Antetokounmpo. Back to Middleton. Here's Maker. Bank shot. No good.
The defense was less than impressive there, but despite them not really contesting that shot, he still bricked it.
No good from the monster.
Oh, great effort there. That's how you defend the paint.
Exactly. Can't play it any better than that, Greg.
Parker kicks to Maker. The shot by Antetokounmpo. Nobody around. And the three ball is good. Antetokounmpo's got 9 points.
Tremendous anticipation from Antetokounmpo, sensing some separation as that pass.
Come on,
is
Kyrie.
Coming.
Yeah, I got another one.
Knocking down the jumper. He's really starting to ramp it up now, getting involved in the offense here after being held without a point in the first.
And the Celtics leadership, very pragmatic. IT and Crowder both beloved in Boston, but they didn't
give me that board
to move them to get better and younger at the same time.
Sinks the triple.
Sweet.
And that's now 9 points for Kyrie Irving.
I love the three-point shooting of Irving. Excellent at dialing it in
from deep, and another board. Got to respect his range. Cleaners in town.
And thinking about the Celtics' choice to get younger, perhaps a strategic move in response
here we go.
To the super team in Golden State. They want to construct their team to peak in a few years, when perhaps when the Warriors start to show a little chink in the armor moving forward.
For three, Middleton. The Bucks getting another chance here.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Smart passes to Horford. To the middle. Here's the monster. And sticking
in
right
one.
With it, gets the foul with the bucket. And he'll
all right. Let's see if we can make the basket here on the foul shot.
Boston making some changes. Morris is checked in for Horford. Tatum comes in for Gordon Hayward.
Get in there. Yeah. All right. And three. For Smart. Yes.
32 seconds left in the first half. Antetokounmpo gets to Henson.
Yeah, my bad.
Henson.
Damn it.
And Antetokounmpo just, I mean, showing you once again what an all-around superb talent he is. I mean, he really moves that ball on offense.
There's the screen. Tatum with it.
Oh, my God, dude.
The kick out to Irvin. Just five to shoot. From 12 feet out, chalk up two there. Irving's got 11 points in the quarter.
And the mid-range shot of Irving is impressive.
All right, down by six at half.
With that shot.
And so it's Milwaukee with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter.
Thanks, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third.
Okay, halftime stats, 10.7 rebounds, 4 assists. All right.
Bobby Parker has been exceptional here today, guys.
Oh, well, they've done a good job of letting the game come to them, and really few forced shots here so far.
And, you know, Greg, I like how they've set the pace. There's a lot of time left in this one, so there's no rush. You don't have to go 70 miles an hour. Keep it at about 45.
Get in there. All
right. Fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade. For the second half of basketball on the court for the Bucks, all the big Bucks up front. Giannis,
no,
and Maker, Ogden and Middleton are the guard tandem,
and nobody, guys, among the defenders stepping up to challenge him on that drive to the 10.
And Greg,
I did
thank you very much and sails in for the flush.
And those are the kind of sequences that tell you why the score is what it is.
How's that for an answer?
Get out
with the dunk.
And guys, right now the defense mentally not there. Can't afford too many of those in a close game like this.
Yeah, Jay, you're right. Almost a free run for him there.
Momentum can swing on plays like that, Kevin, especially when the finish has that much thunder on it.
Oh, that's blocked.
That's right. Get out of here with that.
Smart with the ball.
And we turn it around.
Smart's got 4 points in the quarter.
Comes a timeout.
Three, and that's always a good way to start the second half.
It's Brogdon on the wing. Antetokounmpo against Hayward. Brogdon the pass to Antetokounmpo. And it's Parker at the elbow. It's rebounded
yes.
by the Monster. The Monster's got 7 rebounds in the game. Guys, they've been getting it done.
They came out with a mission. And they have been
all right.
to stop. And I like
let's do it. We tied it up.
Hitting the ball on the interior, 8 of their last 10 coming that way.
Sometimes you just got to man up and take a tough foul in order to stop these free runs to the rim.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. And you watch Antetokounmpo play out there, and he looks like a supersized point guard with how he moves and gallops and initiates the offense. The term is point forward, but the bottom line, Clark, is that Giannis is the orchestrator when he's on the floor.
You're exactly right, Kevin. The assist numbers grow every year for Giannis. He causes a ton of mismatch problems. And how you guard him on the perimeter is always a quandary for the opposing team.
But only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
All right.
And a fast break now for the Celtics. And slam
dunk. Yeah, we got the lead.
And you've got to give them a lot of credit for just battling back into this game.
Extremely impressive was the rally they made. I mean, we'll see how much their comeback might have taken.
My guy. I fell asleep
we'll
there, man.
Keep that foot on the pedal.
Fell asleep.
Oh, An aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think.
That's exactly how you send it. Two hands and down.
Oh, my God.
And that'll be Milwaukee as it goes out of bounds. Bucks retain.
The heck was that?
Brownie's checked in for
Boston. Why did I pass it? I meant to jam it, man.
Tony Snell's checked in for Chris Middleton.
Shoot.
The Bucks have gone
two. Right, get on your guy, man. Get on your guy.
They set the screen. Parker left side. Lands soft.
Come on, really?
Parker's got 4 points this quarter.
Whenever Parker has a look from mid-range, he's going to take it. I mean, he's a very capable shooter from that distance.
Now here is Horford. He is a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. Brown outside. Jacks up a three. Rebound, Milwaukee.
Oh, my God, how did I miss that?
Tonight. Kumbo against Brown. Brogdon kicks to Parker. Hits some rim in, and the bucket's good.
Come on, let's
and
go.
Now a 5-point Milwaukee lead.
Get me in the game here, man. Get me in the game.
Here's the monster covered by Parker. No good from the monster.
Is some tough defense there against one of the
that's rank right there, man. Rank ball handling, rank everything. Rank defense going on.
Maker dishes to Parker. And another basket for Milwaukee.
Defensive breakdown again. Give me a freaking break, coach.
High percentage from the field, really giving this team a boost.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Brown the pass to the monster. Off the run, and it's good on the way in. The monster's got 14 points. Bucks leading by.
Get on the defense, man. Just lock it down.
Here's Snell, 5 points in the game. Screen by Parker. Over in the corner, out of the Kumbo.
God damn it.
By Parker.
You know, when you're defending Parker, you've got to be very. I mean, if you're going to foul this guy.
Yes. Unbelievable.
Milwaukee has gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Screen by Parker. Here's Antetokounmpo and the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
Bad block. I get dinged for a bad block attempt.
Tremendous run here in the third.
A much needed run too, Greg. I mean, they've turned it up a notch. Really taking over now.
Here's the monster, and he dunks it down.
Yes.
Ooh, a forceful finish from the big fella.
Well, a player for that size, you'd think he'd make the highlight reel more often.
Yeah, you know, he just appears to lack an edge at times in his game. I mean, he can be too passive and reluctant on the court.
And the Bucks making a change here. Middleton's checked in.
Get in. All right.
Clark, you were a strong free throw shooter when you played. Why do some big men have such a hard time being at least serviceable at the free throw line?
Well, I'm not as big as some of the biggest guys that have the most trouble. Typically, you see guys north of 6'8", 6'9", struggling tremendously from the line in general. And because of that, I think sometimes it's the mechanics of shooting the ball, and big hands can sometimes be a hindrance to that. Oftentimes, it's a matter of how much do you work at it and how soon do you start working at it. A lot of times, big guys tend to focus on their post moves and scoring the ball close to the bucket and not as much as shooting. But you're seeing more and more big guys with sweet strokes, and I think it's a matter of, again, basic fundamentals,
mechanics, all right,
and putting in hours and hours and hours of work on it.
Wells kicks to Tatum. The monster passes to Morris. Here's the monster, and Henson sends it back.
Hey, that reach of Henson, remarkably shot block. Long, unbelievably long, and that allows him to wipe away shots effectively.
This Let's go, Shammy.
Turbulent outing for him so far. Fortunately, the rest of his team has bailed him out.
No good on the monster. On offense, here are the Bucks. They're on an 18-7 run. Middleton dishes to Teletovich. Teletovich, the screen. Here's Parker, and there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Kevin, he's been flat out phenomenal, superb, scintillating this quarter. He's carving him up, knocking down everything.
The Celtics working the ball around now. The Monster, they get it back. That's it, and the Milwaukee
right.
lead is cut down now to just two.
That's
points.
A bad shot. I thought it was going to be going into the bucket, but it wouldn't let me.
From the three-point line anymore. They had a lot more attempts in that first half.
Now here's Middleton. He's tightly guarded. The dish to Parker. Henson with the screen. Parker kicks to Antetokounmpo. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And so it's the Milwaukee Bucks.
Down by 10.
With a 10-point lead. Some breathing room heading into the break. They're feeling very confident shooting the ball with great other areas.
And you have to
all right,
take
let's
care
go.
Of home base. Otherwise, it's going to be
one more quarter down by 10
night.
Points.
And that's not going to reflect well for you on the scoreboard.
Welcome back. Fourth quarter action starting up. 2K Sports, happy to have you with us. Hayward outside at the three with Morris to his side at the four. Kyrie Irving is out there with Wells. And it's the Monster in at the five down low. That's the Boston five.
And one thing you notice with Giannis is just how much
Kyrie, why are you giving me the ball?
With him on the floor. What he brings on offense and defense is as huge as any player in our league.
Here's Morris. And the shot no good, a bit short.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's been a well-rounded
performance.
I mean, strong rebound and it's been at the center of it, but it's been good on a number of levels.
Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we say about him a lot.
The second chance effort.
Shammy.
We gets the whistle. Contact way up and two shots coming up.
And, you know, Wells has some leadership qualities to him that are appealing. I mean, he's a guy that the younger players don't have any trouble looking up to.
And, Greg, with Giannis, the team is so much more dangerous with him on the floor offensively. And the numbers back it up.
Yeah, Giannis, one of the few difference makers who can impact the game on both ends. Causes a ton of turnovers with his D, but also can facilitate or carry a team with his offense.
Wells in the pass to Middleton. Wells with the steal. And a fast break now for the Celtics. Wells is running. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
Oh man, I had the inside position.
Antetokounmpo kicks to Parker. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Defenders have to be really cautious when defending Parker. I mean, he's an incredible athlete who doesn't mind physicality.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Bucks?
And I like how they've taken the high percentage shot in the paint. In that first half, we saw them doing it, and they've continued to succeed as the game has worn on.
Something that also stands out tonight is the number of assists they have. I mean, that's a mark of a good club.
And one.
This one on the play. Bucket's good. He'll go to the line. It's on Von Maker. Going up, Clark, you were Mr. Basketball USA, a national ranking. Be truthful. How dominant were you in high school in Cleveland, Ohio?
I was a really good high school player, considered one of the top two or three
Let's
in the
go.
Country in 1979, which was actually perhaps the there best high school class ever, documented by many.
Converted another and one.
Isaiah Thomas and Sam Bowie, James Worthy, Ralph Sampson, Dale Ellis, Terry Cummings, Dominique Wilkins. I could go on and on. A terrific class, and I was considered at the top of that class as a high school.
Celtics trail by 10. In the corner, Smart with it. A three-pointer off the mark. For Milwaukee, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. In the corner, it's Brogdon. Now, here's Maker. D right on him. And a great assist by Brogdon.
That was my guy.
That one goes in. Brogdon's got 6 assists here tonight.
That was my guy, man.
Now, a timeout called by Boston.
You know, Malcolm Brogdon,
let's go, guys. Let's go.
Overall pick in 2016 out of Virginia. A little older than most rookies over the last.
Bucks leading by 12. Now Brogdon. Screened by Parker. Brogdon the pass to Teletovich. Passes it to Henson. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee, they first met him coming out of the University of Virginia.
Yeah, hard not to love what he's about. Intelligent, focused, purposed, driven, skilled. I mean, his age may have worked against him in terms of where he was drafted.
Come on.
It got him into a great spot for his long NBA career because he's going to have one.
Here's the monster. Makes it off the glass. The monster's got 12 points here in the second half.
Now that's where you like your shots to come from.
Irving against Brogdon.
Come on, let's
go. Set the pick.
Shoot.
In the corner, it's Maker.
Oh, crap.
And another three for Milwaukee.
Should have stayed on him.
They're shooting from beyond the arc here in the second half.
Greg, no question about it. They found a nice rhythm from deep.
Hayward passes to the monster. Here's Irving.
Come on, Kyrie. Yes.
Irving's got 4 points now in the quarter.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking.
Get on your gun. Get on your damn gun, man.
Basketball. Pound that thing inside.
Parker kicks to Brogdon. Maker with a screen for Brogdon. Down to five on the shot clock. And the officials call goaltending, so they'll award the basket. And Clark, we've heard the term empty stats for players that put up big numbers but didn't impact the game to the same level of those numbers. What do you think about empty stats?
I'm mixed on empty stats. Clearly some stats impact winning more than others, but in this day of analytics, some of the stats that apparently document impact in winning may be overdone as well. Statistics are statistics. They're part of the game, and you evaluate them in the context of a number of
variables.
Okay,
let's go.
They're here to stay. Empty is probably too strong because they're part of the game.
Here's Parker. Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So
come on, goaltending, really? Was that ball coming down?
Close to getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy playing aggressive instead of playing it safe. And clearly you can hear what the crowd thinks about that call.
You sure can. I mean, they erupted as soon as that whistle blew. No time between the call and the eruption.
Milwaukee leading by 16. We've got 1:48 left here in the fourth quarter. Poked away. And a fast break now for the Celtics. Smart leading the charge. No good from the monster.
Milwaukee's got to be shaking me.
Snell dishes to Middleton. Mark, we've seen the bench celebration become almost an art form in the NBA over the past few seasons. Are you surprised? This
guys, come on.
Not at all. Again, when everything is captured and documented, and you're
going to have
creativity
sit down now.
And attention-grabbing celebration. So it's just part of the landscape.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They're trailing by 18. A
come on, let's go.
Left in the fourth quarter. And now let's present our
why can't I advance? This, I don't want to sit there and watch all this. Let's go. Player of the game, Parker.
In the best sense possible, everything about his game has
yeah, I think I'm done.
So no problem for Milwaukee as they get the win.
Man, I didn't get my 10th rebound. I did have points high, a high point game
really
for myself.
You know,
Thank you for joining us. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Allen, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you later.
Finally got that relentless finisher. Four for seven. Okay. And
crazy how fast they turn on you, huh?
That's how it goes, Jug.
Hey, man, they gonna love us again. We just gotta get that W next time.
They better. I can't take this anymore.
Hold up. You know Hannah doesn't want you in there after games.
I know. I was just trying to cheer up DJ about that loss.
And by cheer me up, he means bring me down even more, boo-boo.
Okay, well, then you
can get it, Jug. I know you try.
Right. Sorry, DJ. I better get back to the cleanup crew.
He's a good kid. He wears his heart on his
sleeve. Yeah, I can't even fault him. I know he cares.
You know, you a wise man, DJ.
Thanks.
DJ's son. And you played a great game.
All right. We are going to leave it here. Been a long episode already, so... Yeah, and I'm going to leave that phone call to the next time. So we'll catch you next time on a new Plays NBA 2K18. Thanks for watching. Bye.